Okay, the first thing we will do, we'll be installing the program we use as a server. For that, we type ATP get install xinetd. Then we will install the programs we use for our TFTP service, TFTP and TFTD. I won't be installing anything as I've already installed it. Okay, now let's configure our server. Now we have to create a file called TFTP in 86 xinetd. And we have to write there everything we can see in the screen. Once we have done that, we are going to configure the folder we are going to use for storing the files in our server. We have to create a file called tftp boot in varlib, and we will give it the appropriate permissions. We use chown for changing the owners of the file. And if, just in the case the group no group does not exist in our system, we'll have to create it with group add no group. And we will use chmod for changing the permissions of the folder. Now we have to restart xinetd for applying all the changes we have done. It is necessary to say that there's a bug in the current version of the program, and when you try to upload a file, it will warn you with an error. We can avoid that error creating an empty file in the folder we use as a server with the same name than the file we are trying to upload. We create the empty file with touch and the name of the file we want to create, and we have to give it permission with chmod. Okay, this is the PC of the server, and this is the PC of the client. And here we have only a photo, which we can display with this command. And here we don't have anything. And if we want to download that photo from the server, we just have to start the process of the TFTP with the IP of the server. We are now connected, and we can download the photo with get and the name of the photo. It's downloading. And it's now loaded, and we can display the photo with the same command. And now, if we want to upload a file to the server, we could create one just like, client to like that file. And now, due to the bug I talked about before. We have to create an empty file with the same name and give it permissions with that command. Now we should begin again the TFTP process and upload the file with put then txt. It's now uploaded and we can display it now with the cat command. And as you can see, it's the same command as before. Okay, so that was all. Bye.